Hi, good morning everyone. I am Chavani Ji, working at Shiv Shankar College of Agricultural Engineering and Technology, Mirajgao. Today we are going to discuss the topic pressure measurement devices. So the following are the list of the instrument or device which we can use to calculate or measurement of the pressure. So number one, that is the piezometer. Another one is the U-tube manometer. Then single column manometer. After that, vertical single column manometer. Then inclined single column manometer. Differential manometer, U-tube differential manometer. And last is the inverted U-tube differential manometer. So piezometer, it is the simplest form of the manometer, which is used to measuring the gauge pressure, of which one end of this device is open to the atmosphere and another is connected to the point where pressure is to be measured. And you can see that in the figure number one. Okay, the rise of the liquid gives the pressure head at the point, gives pressure head. And then pressure at point A can be measured with the help of the height of the liquid that we can say that is the small h in the piezometer. So by applying the following equation, we can use the we can calculate the pressure of the piezometer. Okay, and the equation is rho g h, rho multiplied by h multiplied by g, in which rho is the density of liquid, g is the acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height of the liquid. And answer is in the Newton per meter square. Then U-tube manometer. It is the type of the manometer which consists of the glass tube bent in the U-shape, of which one end is connected to the point at which pressure is to be measured, and another point is remained open to the atmosphere, as shown in the figure number two. This tube generally contains the liquid whose specific gravity is greater than the specific gravity than the of the liquid whose the pressure is to be measured. For gauge pressure, let B is the point at which pressure is to be measured, whose value is P, that is the datum line A to A. H1 is the height of the liquid. H1 is the height of the liquid above the datum line. H2 is the height of the heavy liquid above the datum line, that is A. And S1 is the specific gravity of the liquid, light liquid. So rho 1 is the density of light liquid, that is equal to 1000 into S1, means rho 1 is the density of light liquid is equal to 1000 into S1. S2 is the specific gravity of the heavy liquid, and rho 2 is the density of the heavy liquid, that is equal to 1000 into S2. So after simplification, we get the equation, that is P is equal to P2 GH2 minus P1 GH1. By using this equation, we can calculate the pressure through the U-tube manometer. For vacuum pressure, to calculate the vacuum pressure, we can use the following equation, that is the P is equal to minus P2 GH2 plus P1 GH1. Sorry, in this equation, rho 1, P is equal to minus rho 2 GH2 plus rho 1 GH1. That is the corrected. Single column manometer, it is modified version of the, okay, it is modified version of the U-tube manometer, in which reservoir of large cross-sectional area is connected to one of the limb of the manometer, as shown in the figure, that is figure number 3. So the height of the liquid in the limb will be used to measure the pressure. And the limb may be vertical or inclined. On the basis of the limb, this manometer is divided into the two types, that is vertical single column manometer, and another one is the inclined single column manometer. Vertical single column manometer, let XX be the datum line in the reservoir and in the right tube of manometer. It is connected to the pipe. When it is connected to the pipe, okay? So when manometer is connected to the pressure, due to high pressure at point A, the heavy liquid in the reservoir will be pushed down and level will rise in the right tube. You can observe in this figure, that is figure number 3. Let delta H is the fall of the liquid, fall of heavy liquid in the reservoir. H2 is the rise of heavy liquid in the right limb. H1 is the height of the center of the pipe above the datum line. PA, that is the pressure at point A, which is to be measured. A means capital A, that is the cross-sectional area of the reservoir. Then small a, that is cross-sectional area of right tube. S1 and S2 are the specific gravity of the heavy and light liquid. Means specific gravity of liquid in the pipe, that is S1, and S2 is the specific gravity of the heavy liquid in the reservoir. Rho 1, that is the density of liquid in the pipe. Rho 2 is the density of liquid in the reservoir. So after simplification, we get the equation, that is PA is equal to A into H2 by capital A into rho 2 into G, bracket complete, minus rho 1 into G, bracket whole back, bracket complete, plus H2 rho 2 G minus H1 rho 1 G. In next lecture, we will discuss the topic, that is inclined single column manometer, that is another kind of the single column manometer. So be prepared of about today's lecture. Thank you.